List all the waste that you generate at home, school, or during your trips to other places. Could you very easily reduce the generation of these waste, which would be difficult or rather impossible to reduce? Okay, now students, in this question we would be learning the type of waste which is generated at homes or in our schools or college or when we visit the trips, and in what way these waste can be reduced, or is it impossible for these waste to be reduced? Now this is our question. Now first of all, the type of waste which is being generated on a day-to-day basis at home. So the waste which is generated at home are as follows. Plastics. So plastic bags are the one which is being normally used. When we go to a shop, we bring items and we carry them in the plastic bag. So these are the one most waste which is generated at home after we use it. Papers, napkin, toiletries, kitchen waste. So in the kitchen, the organic remains of vegetables. So vegetables and fruits, leaves, all these the waste which is not used, the left out of the vegetables, fruits or the tea leaves, these becomes the kitchen waste. And the domestic waste, which includes human excreta and the broken glasses or anything which is thrown in the dustbin. Now all these are the waste which has been generated at the home. Now similarly, even in schools and colleges, there are many waste which is generated on a day-to-day basis. They include waste papers and plastics, vegetables and fruit peels which are used, the fruits or vegetables which is used in preparing the food in the canteens, food wrapping papers, sewage, etc. And the waste which is generated during trip includes disposable cups, plates, glasses, spoons and discarded food polythene bags. Now these are the different kinds of waste generated in a day-to-day basis. Coming to the second part of the question, is it possible to reduce the generation of the waste? So yes, it is possible to reduce the generation of the waste. If we plan accordingly and change our habitat and lifestyles, we can reduce the waste. For example, plastic papers. Now instead of plastic bags, if you are using cotton bags or paper bags, these kind of waste can be minimized. Now the waste, generally they are categorized into biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste. So any waste which is generated will be classified into these two, biodegradable and non-biodegradable. Now the organic waste, which is further broken down naturally or by biological process, that is which includes microorganism. Now such waste are called as biodegradable waste. Now these waste, they are made up of organic substances. They can be a food waste or waste produced by plants and animals. For example, paper, wood, rags. Now these are also come under biodegradable waste because they can be further broken down by the action of decomposers, that is microorganisms. And the waste which cannot be reduced further or which cannot be broken down by the actions of microorganisms or naturally, now such waste are called as non-biodegradable waste. They remain in the same form in the environment for longer duration. For example, the glass or a metal or plastic polythene articles. So when these are disposed into the environment, they remain in the same form and they're not converted into the simpler form. So such waste, they're called as non-biodegradable waste. Now these biodegradable waste, like organic waste, they can be reduced because if they're collected separately, it can be converted into manure which is used in agriculture. They are the good source of nutrients for the plants to develop. But the non-biodegradable waste, they are very difficult to reduce or eliminate from the environment because microorganisms have no role in breaking down further. Now when these non-biodegradable or a toxic substance, if they accumulate in an organism, then in every trophic level the concentration increases. So it can lead to biomagnification. So we can say it would be difficult or impossible to degrade the or to reduce the non-biodegradable waste because they cannot be further broken down by the action of microorganisms. So the waste generated in schools and colleges, they can be minimized if we think properly or plan properly and use the materials. And then there should be a proper way to dispose the items, and for non-biodegradable substances, if they are reused, recycled, then their concentration in the atmosphere can be reduced, that is, in the environment can be brought down.